Hello everyone, my name is Matthew Hughes. I'm a security researcher and a hacker, and I'd really like to tell you a story. Meet the Dave. The Dave is a vlogger. He's on the internet and he's cool. He loves NASCAR and he wants to tell the whole world about it. And he's pretty popular and he has a few, shall we say, fans? Meet Barry. Barry is a super fan, a bit weird, a bit, one might say, a stalker. And one day Barry decides that he wants to send the Dave a little gift in the post. So I'm going to tell you a little story about how we disclose too much personal information online, how I can pretty much find anything and everything there is to know about you, and how privacy is dead. Get over it. So, I don't know if you guys have seen this before. This is Pipple, and this is the first step to finding anything about anyone. You get a username, you put it in there, it searches the whole internet, blogs, Facebook, Twitter, everything. And it brings it all back and presents it. So from there, Barry has found out Dave's Facebook profile. We've all got Facebook, some of them have secured it. He's done a pretty good job securing it, you can't see his wall. But you can see his groups. And he's in a group like this. It's open, and it's, I've lost my phone. Let's put it on the internet. Great idea. So, So he's now got his phone number, so he can call him late at night and breathe heavily. And now he wants to send him a little gift. So he goes on his personal website. He does a Hughes search, which is a database of everyone's details who's ever registered for a domain. But he's protected them, like I have here. Some people don't do that. But he's determined. So he goes on his Flickr profile. Who's out of Flickr? I presume we all have. He likes to take photos and a lot of cameras, always embed geolocational information on it. And there are tools that basically allow you to pinpoint where people are, aptly called creepy. Guess why? So from here, he works out, he lives in London. And it's not hard to find out, where someone is. If they are if they're not ex-directory, you can just go on his website, type in the name, type in the city, and you've now got their address. So if you're inclined, as Barry is, you can send them a little gift. Let's go to Reddit. So that's how Barry found the Dave's address and phone number, breathed heavily, and sent him what your mum reads. So in conclusion, this should not be as easy as it is, but it is, and it can be done in a few minutes. I wonder if someone had genuinely nefarious motives. What if someone wanted to steal your identity, open a credit card in your name? And the weird thing is, our attitude to privacy has changed. If I went up to you in the street and say, hey, who did you vote for in the last election? You'd tell me to piss off. Why did you put that on your Facebook profile? And we've become incredibly exhibitionist. We tell the world everything. Where we are, our birthday, our phone numbers, everything, our life story. Now, this is a Twitter feed that I like. It's called Need a Debit Card, and it's just people who have posted pictures of the debit card on the internet. Why is your life so important that you have to show your debit card? And it's easy to do. Everything I've shown you is real. It's my job. It's what I do. It's free. It's online. It's not hard. I've just shown you in a couple of minutes how you can find someone's phone number, address. And what does it mean for privacy? If I can find out everything about you sitting in a cafe on my cell phone, really, what does that mean? Privacy, it's died. It's not going back. We've killed it. So I just want to plug a few things that sort of follow on from my talk. Check out Steve Rambam's talk from Hope 8, Privacy's Dead, Get Over It, and a book called The Filter Bubble by Eli Parisa. And go on Facebook, go on Twitter. Have you put stuff on there that scares you? And if you want, you can stalk me. That's my details. Cheers.